right, time now for our rants and raves of the week, and I'm going to start with Dan.
I have a rant for the Red Sox, and this is kind of a general Red Sox thing. You know, you go back a few years when Terry Francona was fired after that collapse of the team. He was the best manager in Red Sox history was subjected to this horrible thrashing on the way out. It was all anonymous, all found its way into the Boston Globe. Made for great reading, by the way, but these really courageous people. This week, a catcher of little note, A.J. Pierzynski, was released. And there was this fairly amazing blog post at WEEI.com by Rob Bradford, again, quoting numerous anonymous team insiders. This time it seemed like it was players just trashing the guy for his attitude, for getting on his phone during the games and not paying attention to his teammates, and just really giving him a good swift kick on the way out. It's like, it made for great reading. I'm not sure I blame Rob Bradford for going with this, but these gutless...
Or Bob Hohler, who wrote the...
Or Bob, yeah, but these gutless wonders, I'm tired of them. Put your name to it if you've got something
to
say.
Then make the reporter put their name to it.
Well, we know there would have been no story. Maybe there shouldn't have been. I don't know.
Mm. All right, Callie.
I have a rave for MSNBC that's bringing Jose Diaz-Balart back to anchoring. He's sort of been in and out of network television, with the exception of Telemundo, where he's the host of Noticiera Telemundo, very popular. Long time ago, he was a part of that experimentation that CBS Morning News was going through, one of a series of hosts that got tossed in and tossed out when nothing seemed to settle. Now they have a good, solid team. So he's taking the place. Chris Jansen just got named to NBC correspondent, moving over from the show that she was anchoring at that time, and he'll be there. And I'm raving about it, not just because I think he does a good job, but this is an acknowledgement of an audience, of a constituency. Hello, wake up, 2014. I'm glad to see it.
Now let's see if he gets an audience.
Well, let's see.
That's always key.
Good luck.
All right, John.
Well, I have a rave for the new owners of The Verb, which is the old Hojo's Motor Lodge Boylston Street behind Fenway Park. And instead of tearing the dump down, they're remodeling it into a kind of a retro homage to the Kenmore Square of the 60s and 70s, the sort of the rat era. And they're going to have copies of Boston Phoenix covers adorning the room. Of course, I wrote for the Phoenix back in the 90s. I don't know if anyone will be...
Any of your headlines in there?
I don't know if anyone's going to want to hop into the tub to soak under my cover story of Evelyn Murphy. Sorry, Evelyn, but we'll see. But I think that's pretty cool, and it raises the prospect of using this technique in other venues. For instance, USA Today, once known as McPaper, you could line the walls of McDonald's with USA Today covers. Or, conversely, at a high-priced $80 steak joint, you could have the Wall Street Journal lining the walls. The 1% could bone up on their ill-gotten gain and chow down at the same time, or, of course, the Boston Herald bus stations. So I think this is definitely a trend that's happening,
and
look for it in my search engine optimization.
I'm looking forward to going in. It's still all gated off. I was just by there the other day, and it still looks like a dump.
I think they're going to leave the gate as part of the retro grunge feel.
It's like a whole, you know, what do you call it, chain link fence.
At least I hope they're hosing the inside down.
All right, well, I have a rant for WOIO in Cleveland, Ohio. They were so desperate to get LeBron James back to the city that they promised to name their sports studio the LeBron James Sports Studio. So now they've done it.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay.
Can you imagine?
No.
Turning over one of your facilities in name anyway. I mean, the John Keller Memorial, you know. WBZ.
I'm still alive. I hate to break it to you.
You can have an homage while you're alive. Well, that's pretty. This reminds me of, this was 100 years ago when one of the stations in Memphis, I'm from Memphis, Tennessee, thought they'd get cute, and they took Isaac Hayes' Shaft and made it their theme song. It was, and cut it to the music.
Oh,
I must say it was quite peppy. Isaac Hayes did not appreciate that.
Oh.
No.
Yeah. I'm just wondering if LeBron's going to pocket a royalty from all this.
That's ridiculous. All right. Thank you so much.